never been interested in doing something a certain way simply because it has always been done that way. I'm always questioning, why? Why do we do it this way or not that way? If I don't know, I'll find out why, and if it doesn't make complete sense to me, I will experiment with new ideas until I get something that totally makes sense. And that's exactly the case with my neurobiology of change presentation. You see, when I was in grad school, relatively little was taught about how the brain actually works. The emphasis was on psychological theory and technique. It wasn't until I actually got out of the program that I discovered the power of learning about the neurobiology of change. Nobody was talking about change and how it really happens at the cellular level in the human brain back in 2002. Perhaps nobody really ever thought about that perspective, but once I got a taste of the science of neuroplasticity, I became obsessed with the idea and passionate about bringing that knowledge to my clients. I reasoned that if this knowledge had such a powerful impact on helping me to visualize what was going on in my head and take the mystery out of why I seemed to keep right on doing the things that I really didn't want to do, it would do the same for others. So I set about the task of creating a presentation that would serve as a visual aid for explaining the concepts to my clients. Now, I don't claim to be a graphic artist, but I do know my way around PowerPoint a bit. So I gathered pictures and images and went to work creating a visual representation of what thoughts really are and how to change them, starting with the smallest component of thought, the synapse. Turns out I was right. My clients loved the presentation. I've had more positive comments about this presentation than probably any other single thing I show people. And with that said, I now commence to bring it to you slide by slide. We'll be right back.